The tones a composer uses are guilty until proven innocent. That then is how it must be. Professional rates of obsolescence tend to be very wild things, whimsically compounded. Other composers of his generation had gone on to conquer avant-garde universes of various sizes and types, ranging from elegant Parisian salons to dreary classrooms in Los Angeles. A métier pursued in isolation from the world at large must be defended against half-skilled eccentrics, small nocturnal talents, word men, compositional illiterates, seekers after shocks, and irresponsibilities, and all the other phenomena that have been so palpably in evidence in the interstitial provinces of contemporary music. Originality is merely one thing. Mastery is something else. There is typical formal propriety in Stravinsky's departing just when the demons he abhorred, amateurism and slovenliness, are enjoying their season in the sun. Every item, small or large, is unique and uniquely positioned within a network of associational mazes. A music circumscribed and isolated by its purity. Imagine myself, as many composers do, in every one of those positions. That's an experience that transcends virtually any pleasure I can think of.